Welcome back, guys. And in the last part, we created this app where when you click on this create PDF, a PDF file is created and hello world is returned to it. Okay, so now we will be learning how we can convert this whole layout or any another layout, XML layout to PDF. So that's first, let's create a button. So as you can see here, I just have a button here that has this text and that has this ID. So whenever the user clicks on this button, we will create, what will we create? We will create a PDF file. All right, so let's jump to the code. So we already had this much to create PDF from nothing and just to write this text into it. But now we will be converting an XML view to what? To PDF. All right, so I've already created this. Now just add reference to this button. To PDF, and whenever the user clicks on this button, we will convert this main activity, that is, we will convert this to PDF. All right, so let's call a function convert XML PDF. We don't have a function, so let's create this function again. Hit Alt Enter, create method in main activity, and let's get started with our code. First of all, we need to inflate the layout, right? Inflate the layout that we want to convert to PDF. So it's inflated like this. If you have not inflated any layout before, this is how you inflate it. Now, I'm not going to details about what you need to pass here, what is this root, and you can pass another parameter that is attached to root, but let's not go into that. You can Google in detail what this is, but basically we're just inflating a layout, and then we need to create a display matrix object. I'll tell you what it is just a minute. Now this display matrix object holds the specifications like width and height and density pixels of a display. So this is just an empty object right now, and later on we will calculate our devices display matrix, like our devices width and height and so on, and it is used to measure this view. Okay, so for now we have an empty display matrix object, and now we need to set our devices height and width to this display matrix object. So if the version of our Android is greater than 10, we have a new function in this case that is what we are doing is we are actually setting the display metrics or the display specifications of our device to this object. Okay, else we have another, I think you might have used this, get window manager, if you wanted to, you know, show full screen, remove status bar and stuff, you might have used that. So in new devices we use this. If the version is lower than R, we use this. Basically we have set our devices length, height, width, and density pixels and all that good stuff in this display matrix variable. Okay, so now that we have, what we need to do is we need to measure our view according to how it would be inflated in our device with this display matrix. All right, so view dot measure, and now here we need to pass measurement specifications, that is, how do we measure this view based on the constraints of its internal views and how it's how it is viewed out on a layout, or how it is laid out in a layout and all that stuff. So let's create those display specifications or measure specifications, and assign this. If this layout was inflated in a device with this specifications, And so this is the width measure specifications and this is the height measure specifications. Now it this measure specs takes exactly and at most unspecified. So this basically means that this layout should take the width of our device and it should be exactly the same size, and the height of the view should take height of our device and it should be exactly the same size. All right, so that means this layout, if inflated, should take whole, it's like a match pairing, match width and match height. Okay, so according to those constraints our view will be measured, and we are doing this so that we can get height and width of view later on. Okay, so now let's just add this. This is basically like drawing the layout so that it can be printed to a PDF. Okay, if the layout is not drawn out, it will not be printed, so we need to add this line also. It's kind of important. In my test, this was kind of important. Then, just like the previous tutorial, we just create a PDF document and we need to set the height and width, right? Like we did last time. I think we have done it somewhere down below, but let's not go into that now. So the width of the document will be the width of our view, and similarly the height of our document will be the height of the view. And now we create the page info. As we had seen earlier, page info contains the information about the width and the height of the page. So let's create a new PDF document dot page info builder. Width, height, and page number is set to 1. And let's create this info. I'll go into more details in just a minute about what these are. And finally we have a page. Okay, so now if you had not seen the previous tutorial, let me just quickly go through what these things are. So first of all, to create a PDF document, we just need to initialize a PDF document object, right? And this PDF document object will create pages like this, and this page is created using the page information that contains like height and width and page number. So page is created using page info, and this page is included in PDF document. All right, so that's how we create pages in PDF. Now, to draw to the page, like we had done before, we need a canvas, right? So let's create a canvas. And this canvas will be kind of like, this canvas is this page's canvas. So whatever we write to this canvas will be written to the page. Okay, if you have not used canvas before, canvas can be pretty powerful tool to draw whatever you want to draw, or, you know, write text. It has a lot of functions, like, as you can see, draw bitmap, draw text, all the stuff. So you can do a lot of custom stuff, more than just printing a layout. You can do a lot with a canvas. So view has a function draw, and where are we drawing this view? We are drawing this view in this canvas, right? So draw this view in this canvas, and let's just finish the page here. Now we mean to say that the page is done. So we write document finish page, our page is finished. All right, so now our PDF is ready. We just need to write this to wherever we want to write this to, or wherever we want to save this document, right? So I'll just copy this from our previous function. That is, where is it? Create PDF. And this is nothing but we are just writing this to downloads directory. And instead of example, I'll just write example XML because example.pdf is created by another button that we click create PDF, and we'll be clicking create XML PDF. So we will save all this into example PDF, and it's written in directory of downloads. You can save it anywhere you want, like you can save it in alarms or documents and stuff, but right now let's just save it in downloads. And then we just have a typical Java file output stream, and we write this document to this output stream. We close the document, we close the file output stream, and we toast return converted. Let's just see this converted XML to PDF successfully, and we have error logs here. Okay, so I think this should work. Let's just run this and try it out. The app is launching again, guys. If this tutorial helped you, then please consider liking, subscribing, and commenting. It would mean a lot to me. And yeah, so just let's click on this button. But our app has crashed. Let's see what the issue is. Okay. Okay, it's saying page width must be positive. So for some reason, view width is this is negative or zero. So what's happening is get measured width. What are we doing here? Okay, it should work. Why is it negative? We will not measure with pixels. Let's minimize this. Okay, so it must be, this must be, where is it? Line number 82. So view width and view height must be being set to zero for some reason. Okay, let me check. Try to move this. Sprint. The issue is here with this again. Let's see what happens. Okay, again, we are getting this error, must be positive. And right now, I think it's not positive. It is kind of positive, it is 1080, as you can see here with this. Sorry, with this 1080. So, what is going on? View width is 1080, view height should also be working fine. Let's read the error properly. It's saying page width must be positive. And this is positive, this is 1080. So I'm not sure what the issue is here. Okay. This is positive. What's going on? Let's try to write 1080 and 980 directly here. 1920. Let's see if this will work. Okay, It says converted XML to PDF. Let's see if it worked. Yep. So as you can see, our layout XML is created to PDF, but we have a problem because it will not always be 1080 and 1920, right? So this is like the full page. It can be less than that, it can be more than this. So we need to figure out why this is not working, because view width is definitely not zero, right? It's 1080, as we can see here. When we print it, it's being printed as 1080, but when we pass it here, it's being shown as zero. Let's check. It's internet. It's let's just try to view width, and this view width is 1080, and let's write view height, and this view height, let's just log for view height also. Anyway, our thing for now is done, but I'm just checking what's wrong with this because it should work. Let's run this again. This is weird because the values are the same as, okay, view height is zero now. Why is view height zero? Okay, I've written get minimum height, get measured height. See, I make stupid mistakes sometimes. My apologies for that. Yeah, it's working now. So if you have any problems, feel free to ask me in the comment section below. And thank you for watching again. Please consider subscribing and liking. It will help me out a lot. Thank you, guys.